Hi everybody, welcome to Reality Buzz TV. So you guys, let's do this part of Uthando Nesithembu episode 15 of season 7. This is like basically part 2. But you guys, listen, I will still do the live, okay? I know tomorrow I won't have time to do any of the reviews. So I'm like, let me do it tonight so that I can post for you while I focus on other things. So listen, you guys. In this part, you guys, they are going out to play golf from Seleku and the wives. Obviously, Umacele is not there. I'm wondering, you guys, is Sekhaya taka regret yini not going to the trip? Is she feeling good about the fact that she did not go on a trip? I just wonder, you guys. No, Wuthi, because the whole family is there by the trip. Obviously, we're not getting anything from Umacele. Nobody is there getting a diary session from Umacele, so that maybe we can possibly get to know how she's feeling about the situation. Okay. Anyway, you guys, they're having fun. They're going to play golf. Umacele and the wives. He's teaching the wives. And you guys, everybody seems to be happy. Okay. Makumalo is happy. Amangwabe is happy. Mayeni is happy. And they seem to get along, you guys. That's a nice thing about this trip, is that everybody is getting along. Okay. Maybe a present, Kamacele, you guys, does have a negative impact on everybody, because how come this is the first trip that the wives are not having any issues with each other? The issues that they're having is just the fact that these wives don't want to spend time with Umacele. They're doing everything they can to avoid spending time with Umseleko, guys. Listen, you guys. So they play golf, they have fun, and then you guys, they started talking about what happened the night before. Remember, when Umakumalo is sitting with Umseleko, Umakumalo calls Umangwabe to say, listen, we talked during breakfast, and you know, I tried to correct you, and I told you to correct your mistake that you made, which was not to give Umseleku any. Okay, so here is your chance. I'm giving you my night. So in my mind, I'm thinking, okay, then Umangwabe must have agreed to replace Umakumalo on this night. Okay, even though I'm also feeling like Umakumalo at night, she's avoiding Umseleku and using Umangwabe as an excuse, because I feel like these wives don't like this husband very much. Guys, why are these people not wanting to spend time with their husband? So then, so she had called Umangwabe. So now when they are discussing it, Umangwabe is like, guys, I got a missed call from you, Seleku, at 1 o'clock last night. Okay. Makumalo is like, no, the missed call was not at 1 o'clock. You must have woken up at 1 o'clock. We called you earlier than that. And the reason we called you is because Pela Business Vumelo and Usogutu you were going to, you know, with Umseleku. She's like, you know what? Then it means we just understand Ananga, because Umseleku apparently had gone to say goodbye. Remember last week? He had gone, because this is the night, remember? So he had gone to everybody saying goodbye, even went to Mangwabe to say goodbye, went to Mayeni. Remember when they were at the passage and Mayeni was doing the weird kiss at Kabulumkaba? Because sometimes, guys, you don't want to kiss the mouth that four other women are kissing. So you're like, okay, it's in Kabulumkaba. So Mayeni, that's how she got away from kissing that mouth that gets kissed by many people. So he had gone to say goodbye to Umangwabe. Umangwabe was going to sleep, and then they go now with Ulonake, Umakumalo, Umseleku. Okay, they have the whole conversation which I did discuss in the first video, but I do feel like we need a live, guys, to talk about that situation, okay, and how you guys are feeling about it, and we will do it, okay, if I can, maybe tomorrow night, okay. If ngibhale kahle this test, ngizobhala tomorrow afternoon, maybe ngo 10 episodes singayenzi live. So now you guys, Mangwabe is like, hi, mina, I don't even remember you guys calling me earlier on. Futhi mina bese ngizilalele ngaphapha mango one, ngabona missed call. And I'm like, I'm confused, because I'm like, ha, Mangwabe, but we heard you speaking on the phone. But guys, I think we have to keep in mind nento he edit, because I was like, but we heard Mangwabe being called and answering phone and agreeing with Yeah, they'll be together, I guess. Or I felt like she was agreeing to that, or maybe they edited it to seem that way. Because Umangwabe is like, I don't even remember that phone call, Mina. Once you came and said goodbye, I went back, and then I fell asleep. Okay, Umselegu just believes because Umangwabe is making excuses. Here's the thing, you guys. I don't think that Umselegu is any better compared to Umangwabe. Okay. So what I'm saying, you guys, is that I don't feel like Umselego is any better compared to Umangwabe, because Umselego, all he does is say negative things about Umangwabe. Guys, even if your wife was not doing the most, I don't know, pleasant of things, okay, and you didn't like what she was doing, but sometimes, especially when you're speaking to other people about your wife, you might not like what your wife is doing with relationship in, but when you're speaking about your wife to other people, you might say a thing or two that is positive about your wife. Umselegu never says anything positive about Mangwabe, and I'm like, how is this woman going to feel attracted to you and wanting to be intimate with you when all you ever say about her is something negative? It's almost like Umselegu wahamba wayothatha iphara lentombazane washada nalo, but there was nothing good about this woman. And even just to say maybe she's a good mom, you know, maybe she's a good mom, maybe she's a hardworking woman, maybe she looks beautiful. He never really says anything positive about Mangwabe. It's always negative, 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 to a point where it's almost like I switch off my Mangwabe, because I'm like, I can't take it. I don't know how Mangwabe takes it, you guys. I do believe that they do get to watch the show, maybe before we get to see the episodes. So I do wonder, you guys, how that feels like to just have your husband just hammer at you. Yes, Mangwabe is not a perfect wife, but she has some her own reasons. Okay, and so just have your husband just hammer and hammer and hammer at you. Umangwabe unenkani, umangwabe is selfish, umangwabe this, umangwabe that, umangwabe vele umangwabe, vele umangwabe, vele. I'm like, nami ngeke ngize ngifune vele ukuthi uzongivakashela, nami ngeke ngivakashele vele if ube ngumangwabe, because I'll be like, why do you want to spend time with this horrible person? Okay, anyway, you guys, so now the thing is, Umakhumalo had given up her night for Mangwabe, but Mangwabe ended up not spending time with Umselik. So I don't know if they ended up being like, okay, then Makumalo was, because there are things that we don't see. I think Pela, the crew, they do go to bed. Once they go to bed, they don't see what's happening with, you know, the cast. Okay. And I don't feel like they put like cameras there just to watch them while they're not there. So things might have happened that they're not on camera. But according to what's on camera, they're saying that Umangwabe never went to Umselegu. So Umselegu also spent another day alone. I'm like, guys, he deserves it. You know why he deserves it? Because he has allowed Umacele to say that when they go on trips, she's the only one that spends time with him. He's never corrected it. He's never tried to negotiate it and say, listen, you allowed me to take more than one wife, so the other wives are here. I cannot just be sleeping in your room. So when the other wives don't want to sleep with him when they're on a trip, let them be. Let them be, you guys. So listen, Omayen just couldn't believe the whole thing. Like, really, like for the second night now, you're not getting any. Okay, I feel like Omayen probably is the one that will probably give it to him. Okay, maybe this night when it's Omayen's night, he's going to get it. But here's the thing, you guys. When Umakhumalo is explaining the thing of she gave her day to Mangwabe, Umayeni does say, listen, I would have done the same thing. And I was like, oh, because I was shocked by that, because I didn't understand why Umakhumalo was giving up her day. I'm like, why are you giving up your day? Are you giving it up because you are sacrificing for Mangwabe, or are you giving it up because now you don't want to spend time with this man, because now you've had it up to here with this man? And remember, he just wanted her to lie. So maybe she was even a little bit upset about that to Makumalo, but she didn't want to show. She's like, let me just give up my night. Okay. So Mayen is like, Nami, I would have done the same, because she says that it was clear that Umselegu was upset about not being with Umangwabe. Remember, because I've said that I feel like Umselegu is really in love with Umangwabe out of all of the wives. And maybe it is a toxic thing of he wants her more than the other wives because she doesn't want him. Okay, it's like, how dare you don't want me? kind of a situation. So Umayeni says, no, clearly Umseliku was not okay after he did not get it with Umangwabe. So had it been her who was next, she would have done the same to say, listen, since you are so upset about not getting your time with Umangwabe, take my day and go be with Umangwabe. And I started feeling like none of these women want to be with this man. They are not fighting over the days. They're like, listen, if you want the day, do you want my day? Take it. Do you want my night? Take it. Another one? Take it. Hey. Anyway, you guys, how? So now, earlier on, you guys, they had showed us Abu has to go back to Joburg. I think Bandlalela ingane zesithembu, because they were talking about going to Joburg with Mpilo, and they asked Usne as well to come. Usne ended up refusing to go. And yeah, so Abu is going back to Joburg. And then, you guys, they were going to... Oh, before I go to the last dinner. Okay. Then Umakhumalo and Umangwabe decided to stay behind while they were going back to the place where they stay. At the golf place, okay, they were going to have some drinks. I do believe that Umakhumalo and Umangwabe got a phone. Remember, Umseliku was a phone because he's a poser. I believe Umakhumalo may phone Uvelati, my friend. We are sad. We are the secret. It's a cocktail one, cocktail two. So they go to spend time together. So now, Umseliku is thinking Umakhumalo is going to try and advise Umangwabe what. When they get there, Umakhumalo is like, hey, God, I understand you, kancane, you know. I said, partly I do understand, because, you know, we all know that when we are on a trip, this is what happens. He sleeps wherever he sleeps, you know. So now why would you think that it's going to be you? And also Umangwabe says, so when I came, I did try to get clarity from him. I go to, okay, so you have your own room. How is this going to work? And he brushed me off. So I guess Umangwabe was like, oh, okay. Okay. Remember, Umakhumalo agekula. So, you know, that's what happened. She tried to get that clarity. So Umakhumalo is like, hish, I don't blame you. You know, in front of him, I'm going to pretend like I blame you. But I don't blame you, because we all know what happens. Okay. Now, you guys, there's dinner for the family. It's the last dinner at the trip. They're ending the trip. Beautiful setup. Lots of food there. The kids are there. But Umakhumalo apparently has to leave with Mpilo. And then I guess because they have to go somewhere, and Kuna something about her dropping off Mpilo at school. And I was wondering which school is Mpilo at? You know, I haven't paid attention to know what to. I need to, okay. And then Usne wanted to go with them. And then Umseliku makes a point to make a comment. Usne just wants to go back. Ufuna ukubuyela endodeni yakhe, not ukuthi kwenzekani. You know, that's why ifuna ukuhamba. So I thought about it and I was like, maybe he's right about Umseliku. But you know, as a parent, sometimes you have to be conscious of certain things when it comes to your kids. Because when Umakhumalo is leaving, Mpilo is also leaving. He doesn't make a comment to say Mpilo probably wants to go to see her boyfriend, but he makes that comment about Usne. And you might say, but we don't know anything about Mpilo dating anybody. Yeah, but sometimes as a parent, you have to think about such. How is it going to feel? They are both his daughters, and they are both deciding to live with Umawabo, Umakhumalo. So why is it that for Usne, I fungo boni daughter lo, but with Mpilo, nothing is said, okay, because the princess of the family, okay. Anyway, you guys, Umseliku ended up making a comment on Umangwabe. Like I said, guys, I think partly kune switch manje in my brain that when Umseliku is speaking about these negative things about Umangwabe, kuvele kuthi switch, you know. It's too much, okay? So, you guys, while they're sitting at the table, the others have left. And then that is where they continue with the conversation. Because now everything is about Umseliku and not getting any. As if it's the only thing in life that is important. And then Umangwabe just decides, you know what? Let me just... It's in flat tail. Meaning Umayeni, no Musa Umseliku. So, she gives them her back. And then Umseliku, guys, right there at the table, when the kids are there, he's like, how? So funu kung nika nge move. In front of the kids. the inappropriate conversations those kids hear. How? Guys, because I was watching it on catch up and it's, did he just say that? And I'm like, there was Mpumelelo, there was, you know, the adult kid, they know what that means, ne? Clearly, because Mpumelelo has kids who's, you know, but I'm like, but that is not a conversation to have. Guys, people are going to say no, but you know, you can talk about sex in front of him, but that, for no one can move. Hey, then the child there at the end of the table makes a comment to say, hey, amantombazane, I like Texas because, you know, a taxi kungena wonke umuntu onemali. If you have money, you can get in a taxi. That's how girls are. They are being, you know, they get, everybody proposes to a girl as long as you have money, they, you know, you have a chance, that kind of a comment. Then everybody is shocked that that child is making that comment when the father is sitting at the table having making these inappropriate comments with his wives. I'm like, why are we shocked? Why are we shocked? Okay. And I do feel like Umayene was embarrassed, you guys. And she did say that it's inappropriate sometimes because laughed. You know, I think it's easy to laugh. I've seen it with the with different kids. When a child is doing something embarrassing or something that is not appropriate, the other wives would laugh. But the wife that is a mother to the child usually doesn't laugh, you know. And it was the same. Umayene was more like, hey, we might think it's funny, but to other people, it might not be so funny. And she also thought it was something big for it to come from Umnene. Okay. It says this comment. And he does say, shame in the title session, he doesn't think that his mom would get mad about it because he really was joking. But it is weird, you guys, that a child that age will joke like that when it comes to girls. I think it's early enough for them to correct it. But I do feel like it's not going to get corrected because that is how women are treated. So they are like Texas. In the household that I'm selling, so I guess it's gonna be difficult to correct, but I think he is young enough for it to be corrected. Okay, anyway, you guys, I don't know if he gets it that it was inappropriate to make that comment, but I hope somebody is able to have that conversation with him later on. Maybe Babu Mseligu will decide to respond to us next season and sit down with Umnenike and have that conversation, you guys. Anyway. That was a trip, you guys, because that was the end of the trip. We don't know what's going to happen now. I think next time we see them, they will be back at home because we see Mseligu sitting with Magdalene having some type of a conversation with her and about her take, about him taking number five, Uzi, whatever, guys. Listen, I never really want to get through the number five story because it's the most boring storyline that we've ever got that was never going to happen. So until I see, like, here is number five. I'm never going to believe that number five is coming. But they always want to make us believe it was number five for Zai. Then Mpumelelo is also going to be talking to Abakongi, the guys that will be going to negotiate Ilobola for the wives. And he's talking about the virgin being the first one that will be negotiated for. You know, that shock of our life that we got beginning of the season, that he actually is going to take a virgin as his first wife. Anyway, you guys, that was the episode for today. Here is the thing, you guys. I hope they have a better season next season for us on Uthando Lwesithembu. I think that they mustn't be concerned so much about what we are talking about. They must just do the show and not be so concerned about, oh, the viewers are saying this. Let's sit down and discuss this so we respond, because it just feels weird. Every time we say something online, they sit down, they have a conversation about it. Maybe it's because they've run out of content, but, you know. Anyway, you guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Please like it before you're going to share it with your friends, with your family, and even with strangers.